What to Play presents 25 of the best PC 2D platformers of all time, all arranged by play scores. To check out our full list, visit our website at whattoplay.com. You can take part in our rankings by leaving reviews of the games that you played. Starting off our list at 25 is Lair of the Clockwork God. Join Ben and Dan as they go on a time-bending adventure to stop the whole universe from falling apart. Switch between these characters and solve a multitude of puzzles that range from impressive to downright hilarious. It combines point-and-click gameplay into its fast-paced platforming. A play score of 8.79. 24th place is Fez. Fez's fourth wall-breaking gameplay sets it apart from all the titles here. While it acts as a 2D game, the gameplay gimmick of shifting perspectives to different dimensions transforms its world into a trippy adventure. A play score of 8.80. 23rd in the list is Limbo. Playdead's award-winning title is a hallmark of the genre. The monochromatic journey of this young boy has etched itself among gaming's best moments. The puzzles and platforming may show their age today, but during its time, its ingenious level designs brought something new to the genre, a play score of 8.80. Coming in at 22nd is Creaks. Amanita Design's latest project after the success of Machinarium and Samorost is another surreal puzzle experience powered by their fantastic, handcrafted art style. Explore this odd dimension riddled with mysteries and teeming with anthropomorphic birds. It receives a play score of 8.81. 21st in the list is Yoku's Island Express. A breath of fresh air compared to most on this list, Yoku's unique spin to the 2D platformer genre gives it a new direction to experiment on. The pinball mechanics may be weird at first, but navigating around its tricky levels is impossible without mastering trajectories. It has a play score of 8.82. 20th spot is Super Meat Boy. The king of all platformers takes over our 20th spot. 11 years ago, Edmund McMillan's bizarre and challenging 2D title was hailed as one of the best platformers of all time. The levels are designed to piss players off, and that's always been the game's charm. Anyone who rage quits can't fathom the greatness that is Super Meat Boy. A play score of 8.83. Ranked 19th is Broforce. If Super Meat Boy is the king of all platformers, Broforce's testosterone-fueled action makes it the chattest title of the genre. Play with a bro and go on a retro-packed adventure that is reminiscent of the days of 80s action films. Explode red barrels, shoot guns, and go on a barrage of bullets. It receives a play score of 8.87. 18th place is The Swapper. This science fiction platformer is all about being at two or three places at once. The Swapper's cloning mechanic can let players navigate and solve its ingenious puzzles by duplicating their character. Its clay-like art style has an atmosphere worthy of its awards. A play score of 8.90. Our 17th entry is Hunt Down. Remember the game Contra? Well, Coffee Stain's arcadey action platformer is a time machine that takes players back to the good old days of coin-operated gaming. Hunt Down's futuristic world with rich 80s aesthetics is impressive. Its wide variety of action-packed moments is best played with a friend via co-op. A play score of 8.90. 16th place is Towerfall Ascension. From the publisher behind Celeste, Towerfall Ascension is a fun 2D platformer that encourages co-op with friends and family. Its archery-based combat makes room for some hilarious and oftentimes intense battles with other players. A story mode is also available for anyone looking for fresh narratives, but where the game truly shines is in its multiplayer mayhem. A play score of 8.92. 15th entry is SteamWorld Dig 2. Image Informe's Metroidvania Adventure is a fantastic sequel, offering a serving of burrowing bonanza Just like the first game, players dig their way through numerous obstacles and levels, use a variety of gear to unlock secrets, and take on the game's bigger challenges. As a lone steambot with a knack for adventure, uncover what lies beneath in this mysterious and quiet little town. A play score of 8.94. 14th titled is Battle Block Theater. A comedy platform from In the Behemoth, Battle Block Theater's charm is in its co-op adventure. Sure, a solo experience is enjoyable too, but taking in all the hilarity of its story might be better when playing with a partner. Save Hattie Haddington and watch out for the production roadblocks and the theater's feline inhabitants. A play score of 8.95. 13th in our list is Rayman Legends. Ubisoft's sublime platformer is a worthy entry to this list. Lead the gang in a picturesque adventure filled with psychedelic wonder. Jam to its feisty beats and take a ride through the most trippy Rayman Legends experience ever. A play score of 8.95. 12th place is Grizz. Devolver Digital's somber tale about a girl dealing with grief is made poetic by its impressive art direction. Grizz's dynamic colors give meaning to each of its emotional levels. The puzzles aren't too difficult, and the game encourages players to keep moving around. A play score of 8.98. Our 11th entry is Katana Zero. A fast-paced, 2D platformer set in a sprawling cyberpunk society, play as a drug-crazed, katana-wielding protagonist and face off against hordes of capitalist scum. It's slick, action-packed, and has a great soundtrack, and it's made even better by its rewind mechanic. Observe enemy patterns before slicing and dicing their insides in a satisfying bloodbath. A play score of 8.99. Holding down 10th place is Spelunky 2. If we're talking about platformers here, Derek Yu's passion project was among the first to embrace the concept of the roguelike. Just like the original, Spelunky 2 is a brutal and unforgiving 2D platformer, with every run feeling unique. Despite its challenging difficulty, the game builds upon the first game's success by improving its randomized torture chambers. Spelunky 2 receives a play score of 8.99. Coming in at 9th is Inside. Limbo's success pushed Playdead to innovate their platforming repertoire. Inside was a huge step up from their first title. It is a roller coaster of emotions for everyone. The game's dystopian setting builds enough immersion to lure us into its bleak world. It's best experienced blind, and it receives a play score of 9.01. Our 8th entry is Shovel Knight Treasure Trove. Yacht Club Games' award-winning 2D platformer is a familiar yet fresh take on the genre. Treasure Trove is the definitive edition of the Shovel Knight experience. The little knight and his shovel isn't the only story worth playing here. Enjoy all DLCs with its new characters and varied platforming gameplay. A play score of 9.03. Drawing the 7th ranking is Cuphead. The bizarre yet colorful 2D run-and-gun platformer from Studio MDHR is a celebration of the golden age of 1930s cartoons. Free Cuphead and Mugman from the chains of the devil by fulfilling contracts. Brave through its challenging boss rush and grab a friend in co-op. A play score of 9.04. 6th place is Mark of the Ninja. Become one with the shadows in this 2012 stealth platformer from Klai Entertainment. Traverse through its oriental fortresses and avoid tricky traps and oblivious guards. It's a game that encourages players to live by the ninja code. A play score of 9.05. 5th in the list is Hollow Knight. Team Cherry's beloved Metroidvania has charmed us with its adorable art style and punishing combat. Lead this lowly warrior with his little nail in the bug-infested hollow nest and uncover the truth behind the game's lore. Meet fascinating characters along the way and face off against its menacing selection of boss fights. Give us Silksong, please! Hollow Knight receives a play score of 9.07. Fourth spot is Gunpoint. Similar to Mark of the Ninja, this embraces stealth in an urban jungle littered with corruption and villainy. Players assume the role of a spy, using a variety of high-tech toys to silently fulfill his objectives. It's one shot, one kill, so the difficulty can be challenging for new players. A play score of 9.10. Ranking third is Dead Cells. Motion Twin's critically acclaimed platformer slash roguelike has dominated the charts since it came out. It's heavily praised for its free-flowing combat and the endless cycle of life and death. Players will have to mix and match various abilities and weapons at their disposal to make it to the end of the journey. A play score of 9.15. Second place is Ori and the Will of the Wisps. The sequel to the award-winning game from Moon Studios, Ori is once again taken into a new adventure in search of a new purpose. Navigate around its gorgeous land with the use of Ori's new and familiar abilities. It's an emotional journey. Though not as hard-hitting as the first game, it makes up for it with its solid platforming gameplay. A play score of 9.20. Standing on top at number 1 is Celeste. Taking the highest point of our list is none other than this multi-award-winning masterpiece from Matt Makes Games. Celeste's responsive controls and brain-teasing platforming challenges is enough to lure players into Madeline's journey of self-discovery. Packed with only dash, jump, and climb abilities, there's a lot of gameplay variety that keeps the ascent from becoming boring. It receives a play score of 9.21.